Commerce Clay was initiated 6 years back with the aim to help commerce students to get well acquainted with all the options that are available to them other than the already prominent one and oversaturated one like CA and CS, which in turn will help students in making well-informed career decisions. So how does Commerce Clay community actually works? It is very simple. All you have to do is just go to community.commerceclay.com. Create your account by entering your few details and you are ready to ask career-oriented questions and get personal career counseling sessions as well. But you do have to book your sessions. So please just check out the website and book your sessions. And before we move forward with the session, I would like to introduce our moderator for the session, Mr. Shreyans Talikja. He is a rank holder in 2 ACCA papers. He is an ACCA member since 2019. He has worked as an associate consultant at KPMG, as an associate professor and student advisor at GCEC. Please welcome Shreyans Talikja. Over to you, sir.
Okay, thank you, Manu. Thanks so much. I hope that participants are able to listen to clearly. I mean, I think you might have a feature to raise your hand or, you know, just give a thumbs up or something so that we can check it out. Because I would not like anyone to have any problems, right? So let's just clear this thing up and then we'll start. Okay, so the way that this session goes is I have a few very basic things to share and then we have a lot of questions to ask to the wonderful people that have, you know, taken out their time to share their understandings of the career with us. I see that a lot of students will join in. So there are a lot of people now as well, and there are a lot of people who would be joining in as well. So that's okay. I think we are good enough to go and we shouldn't waste any further time. All right, so I'll start by introducing the people that we have here who will probably be answering all the questions. So first we have Tashweta. She, as far as I know, she's one of the youngest ACC affiliates in the world. And I also recently got to know that she's working with a UK-based firm on compliance and tax-related issues. Then we have Christian, sir. And Christian's from the ACCA team. He's also voted as one of the top leaders in education. And apart from that, what really matters to us people is that he's worked extensively in building the job opportunities for ACCA graduates in India and has also developed, you know, a lot of work with a lot of universities to develop programs there. We also have Pooja ma'am. She's the academic director at GCEC. She takes care of all the ACCA stuff that goes around. I think she's been teaching ACCA for what, like 6+ years now. And she's a chartered accountant. She has a PhD in power sector valuations and has worked at a lot of places. So, I mean, you just get to know the kind of people that we have here. Okay, so I'll just start over with a brief overview of ACCA and then we'll move on to the questions. So let's just talk of simple things. There are 13 papers in ACCA. It's a professional accounting and finance based course, right? So it is divided into 3+6+4 papers, right? We understand the group system that is not there in ACCA. You have to clear the papers individually and any professional course is never complete without the practical experience, which everyone should pay special attention to. So you have 36 months of practical experience. It's not necessary that you have to work under an ACCA, but there are certain performance objectives that you're required to meet. So that is the important thing, that you're doing good quality work there, right? And you can start pursuing this course directly after 12th or even before 12th as well, right? There are separate routes for that as well. And the job market is still up and growing when it comes to that. And we'll discuss a lot about that later in the session. Okay, so that was just a brief basic overview. So just that we know what we're dealing with. And now it's time to understand about each point, that what's the course, what's the scope, how to study, what are the job opportunities, so on and so forth. So first, I'll start by asking Christian sir this question, is that there are lots of international courses as well, right? So the first thing is, what is it about ACCA that is different from all of the other international courses, not just professional international courses, but also there are lots of graduation courses also that fascinate a lot of Indian students. So that is one aspect, that how is ACCA different from other international courses. And the second aspect is that, you know, international courses are usually very expensive, right? I mean, we understand that European and American institutes and universities, I mean, we understand the currency difference, so that is why it can get a bit challenging. So what's that point of view for Indian students? Christian sir, over to you.
Thank you so much, Shreyans, and I hope everybody is able to hear me. Yeah?
Yeah.
Great. So, Shreyans, let me start with giving you an overview about what we are. So what organization ACCA is all about. So ACCA is a young organization because obviously we deal with young people like you, right? So we are a young organization which has already spent around 116 years in the industry. We started in the year 1904 as Association of Chartered Certified Accountants, and currently we are based across 180 countries globally. We have got more than 5.5 lakh plus students who are pursuing this qualification, and around 2,27,000 people like you who are members of this qualification. Right. We also work with 7,291 plus employers. Now, these are employers are known as approved employers of ACCA, who actually help the students in getting their PERs. They also help in getting them employability opportunity once they have completed their program with ACCA. And also they come back to us and tell us that, okay, we have got people who are not qualified. So can you help them in getting qualified? So we support them there too. Now, when you look at foreign courses, international courses, yes, Shreyans, they are expensive when those are done in the foreign countries. So in case you move to a foreign
So you went on mute. I just unmute. See what I can do from this side.
Sorry, I can't unmute myself. I wasn't able to do that. So what I was saying is that, yes, when you go to a foreign country, obviously a foreign course becomes expensive because you have a travel cost, you have accommodation related cost, and the other costs which are in the foreign currency only. However, when a course comes to your city, your country, obviously it becomes slightly affordable. And that's what we have done. We have ensured that the qualification remains as affordable as it should be for India, right? Although we are a global organization, but we have to behave locally as per the requirements of the country. So you can call us a global qualification going forward. When I say global, we still remain globally relevant. We ensure that we give the same curriculum to the students across the world. We also ensure that the pedagogy remains the same across the world. The examination date and time also for the qualification remains the same across the world. And the designation ACCA also remains the same across the world. And that too at a cost which is 1/10 of the total cost versus if you travel down to, say, UK to pursue this qualification, right? So these are the basic advantages when you look at our course. In fact, Shreyans, you'll agree with me that if you want to go and do a MBA from a C-grade institute also, you have to spend at least 15 to 20 lakhs, right, in today's condition. With ACCA, when I mentioned about this fee, ACCA fee would be 1/10 of that. And the good thing with ACCA is that you pay as you go. You don't pay the entire fee in one go, right? You have to pay paper-wise. So each paper, whenever you pick up a paper and write that paper, you only pay the examination fee towards that paper. So it actually makes the qualification more affordable and no pinch towards the pockets of the parents. Yeah.
Right. So that's one very important thing to all the students or the attendees here. If you want to understand about the, you know, the course fee breakup and all the details, you can easily find it on the ACCA website, or just go to Google and search ACCA fees and you'll be redirected to the link there. SEO is good that way. Right. Now, I want to come to Tashweta and I want to ask her that because she began ACC at a very young age, right? So one, you need to have clarity about what you want to do and what was your reasoning of choosing this course per se amongst so many other opportunities or so many other courses that we have.
Yeah, so I hope I'm audible to you, Shreyans. Yeah.
Okay. Perfectly. Tashweta, you're on mute now. I think, yes, now it's good.
Yeah, so the one thing which made me choose ACCA was its global presence. You know, it's available in like every country. So today if I'm working, you know, with the client, so I'm not working with any firm, it's my own startup. So
that's amazing.
So we can get clients from like every country. If I would have done any local qualification, I could get local clients, right? Right now I'm getting clients from Australia, from Canada, from UK, of course, and even from the parts of Europe. So that makes you have a big exposure, a better exposure, and a better coverage of clients as well. So that was one thing. And anyway, when I started ACC, I was not eligible for any other course. It was the only course which I was eligible for. So yeah, so that made me choose ACC, and I am very like obliged that I chose this. And till now, my journey has been great, fantastic. And I couldn't have opted for anything better than this.
Okay, that's very reassuring to hear, I am sure, for a lot of the students. Right now, the third thing that I want to talk about is, I would first want to come to Krishan to this, and I'll also want Pooja to pitch in later, is that there are different ways in which you can study ACCA, right? So I would request Krishan to share a little bit about how to study it independently, what's the university program structure, for example, a BCom plus ACCA or a BBA plus ACCA, and then I would want Pooja. Right, my apologies, I went on mute. Right, I think everyone has been a victim of this now, at least one. Anyway, so yes, Krishan sir, please, I would request you to explain, you know, the different ways in which any student can pursue ACCA.
Right, thank you, Shreyans, for asking this very, very important question. And let me start with the entry routes towards the ACCA qualification, and then I'll come to the university programs and the other ways in which one can do that. So you can start the ACCA qualification by the time you touch the age of 13, right? So that's one of the youngest persons can join the ACCA if he or she is hardly 13 years of age, which means they are in class 8th or 9th. They can actually initiate studying ACCA at that age. And this is the only qualification which you can actually pursue when I'm talking about professional qualifications, right? Before your 12th. So that's the opportunity. In fact, students can start in school, complete their diploma or advanced diploma by the time they complete their 12th. Obviously, Tashwita has been a different candidate altogether. She completed the entire ACCA qualification by the time she completed her 12th. Not everybody can do that, but definitely students can look forward to completing the some part of the qualification at that time only, independently or maybe through a learning partner. That's an option which is there with the students. They can self-study and prepare. They can do it through the learning partner. In fact, in case they are in a school which is actually supported by ACCA, because there are a lot of schools who are integrating the ACCA curriculum now at the initial level. For the students in class 11th and 12th, so they can pursue the diploma at least at that level. Now, post 10 plus 2, there are various options. They can look forward to studying with a learning partner. We have got more than 40 plus learning partners across the country. They can very well go ahead and study there. They can go ahead and study in a university, right? So we work with 97 plus universities in the country today, wherein we are offering a BCom or a BBA course, wherein the program is integrated with the BCom or the BBA program of the university. And the student, when he writes examination, he writes one exam and gets two qualifications. So he gets a BCom or a BBA from the university. Plus to that, he or she will be able to complete the ACCA qualification during those days. In case you are already a BCom, obviously you can join the ACCA qualification by getting four exemptions. The first four papers are exempted for you. In case you have done intermediate of CA, obviously, you can get five exemptions, and BCom plus IPCC, the intermediate, gives you six exemptions. And in case you are a chartered accountant, you can actually look forward to getting into the professional level straight, and you get nine paper exemptions from ACCA qualification. So there are various routes. You can choose your route basis the kind of qualification you already possess. We give due credit to the qualification which has already been possessed by the students. So that's definitely there with ACCA. ACCA gives you various other qualifications along with one qualification. Once you write the first three exams, you get a diploma in accounting and business. When you write the next set of six exams, you get an advanced diploma in accounting and business. If you submit a dissertation report to Oxford Brookes University, you get a BSc honors in applied accounting also from Oxford Brookes while you are in India. In fact, you can go ahead and attend the convocation ceremony which happens in Dubai, Singapore and London. So that choice is there with the students. Right, and post that, obviously, when they complete the entire ACCA qualification, they can very well go ahead and pursue the MSc in Professional Accountancy from University of London, which is amongst the top 10 in the world, which Tashwita is right now pursuing. Right, so I just thought of giving all those things, Shreyans. And yeah, over to Pooja now. Pooja, over to you.
Yeah, thank you, Krishan. Thank you, Shreyans. Yeah, so I think thank you, Krishan, for throwing light on how to, like, what are the various modes of doing this course. So one is individual mode. Yes, the student can opt for individual papers either through some learning partner or studying, all by himself or herself, right from, let's say, 10th grade or 9th grade, whatever. And the other mode, which I would really want to lay some importance upon, is the university model. So in our university, like, what we have done is we have integrated the graduation program, the commerce graduation program, along with the ACCA qualification, where we kind of have distributed all the 13 papers in the 3 years of graduation program, and the students, they study with us. So I would like to say that I think the importance here is, or the good part about this the setup is that, you know, we kind of keep mentorship throughout the 3 years. So we are kind of helping the students to clear the papers. In fact, we have been producing some very good results. So we have been producing some rank holders for the last 3-4 years. And what we have also done is, as you said, that every qualification also requires a practical experience. So in ACC also, you have per requirement to be fulfilled. Now, what we have done is we have actually integrated that practical requirement into our marking system. Right, so our result is also based on how well do you perform at your internships, right? So that internships or the practical training has become a necessary part of the graduation program. So what we have tried to do is that we have tried to kind of make the graduation program more sensible or more apt in for today's time. So keeping in mind the ACC syllabus. So majorly what we have done is we have designed the program in a way that in the 3 years you're going to finish your qualification if we are able to clear all the papers in one attempt, and alongside you will be able to finish your 3-year practical training. So by the time you are done with your graduation, as Krishan said, that you study one paper and you get two qualifications, so you will be an AC member and you will also be a graduate. Having said that, also I would want to Shyans is our student. He has been our student. He has got ranks 2 times, All India rank. So yes, I feel little pride to share that we have had some very good results, and we are continuously doing that. In case of any queries, if the students have about this integrated program, they can always reach out to me. I'll share my details. Rest, Shyans, I think you can take over from now because we are running short of time. Thank you.
No worries. Now, the next thing that I want to talk about is that how can one student or candidate, how do they plan their, studies along with work experience, right? Because what mostly happens is that people first do their exams and then, or their education or whatever, and then they go and start working, right? But is there, I know that there is a way to do your exams and exams and work experience side by side. So I would actually want Shweta to pitch in here. Is that how did you manage your studies? Because I understand you did it very quickly as well, and work experience alongside, and then we'll take it from there.
Yeah. So my suggestion to the students every time is that, if you're supposed to get a practical experience, you should start with it after 9 papers, not before that, because personally, my opinion is that you should start it after 9 exams, because before that, you're in your foundation building stage, right? And even there are not much employers who would trust you or will give you better opportunities before the 9 papers. So after 9 exams, go for the practical experience, and then the question arises that how to manage our professional papers and the practical experience together. Now that thing is you have to manage your time. You have to be very clear with your employer. Like I did my internship in Noida. So I was supposed to, tell my employer that, guys, I have my exam, so you need to excuse me for these days. And if they are okay in the interview stage itself, you have to make yourself clear in the interview stage that I'll be giving my attempts on these months, and I would require leaves and I would require assistance from your side. So that thing is very important. Don't be sugar-coated or don't be very buttery with your employer at that stage. Okay, be very clear that I want the leaves at that point in time. So make yourself very clear, and you can give 1 exam in 1 quarter. That's what we can compromise on when we are doing a practical experience together with the studies. So give 1 exam. If you're doing full-time studies, then two exams is a very good option with you. Two exams are easily manageable in one quarter. So yeah, that's my advice.
Okay, I mean, that sounds like, it sounds very logical, a very good way to approach it, right? Now, now the couple of things that I want to talk about is that on practical experience only. So I would want actually Krishan to explain a little bit here from a couple of perspectives, right? Now, the first is that, you know, in fact, we'll start from the entrance itself. Is one, what is the basic qualification required to enter or start the ACCA program, right? For example, let's say after 12th, because most of the students that are here, I understand, are from 11th and 12th, right? And so after 12th, what's the basic eligibility, so to speak, to enter the program, right? What is the relevance of practical experience that the students go through? And I understand that ACCA is doing efforts on the employability side to make the candidates more employable, so probably could share a little bit about that.
Sure, Shreyans. I think a very, very important and a relevant question once again. Thank you for asking this one. Now, if you look at the current situation, Shreyans, after 12th, if somebody wants to get into ACCA, obviously they need to be completing their 10 plus 2 with at least 65% marks in maths. That's important to get into the ACCA qualification per se. Although there is another route of FIA, which is Foundations in Accounting, which can be started before that also. So that's another route which students can take. Talking about practical experience requirement, yes, our practical experience requirement is very much flexible. So it can be before the qualification, it can be during the qualification, it can be after the qualification. So all three options are there with the candidates. Like for example, Pooja is already a qualified accountant. She has already spent, say, more than 16, 17 years in educating people, right? So if she gets into the ACCA qualification today, she need not go for the experience because she already carries that experience with her, right? So she can file her PER automatically. For example, Shreyans, you did not do your PER, just an example, right? And you started with KPMG, say, 2 years back. So you would have completed 2 years of experience, and that is after your qualification, right? There'll be candidates who can do it during the qualification. They might be working with an organization today, right? And they go ahead and complete their work experience alongside there. The second option is, as Pooja rightly mentioned, at GCEC, wherein you are offering the PER opportunities to the student. In the similar way, there are other employers in the market who have started offering the practical experience requirement opportunities to the students. They are supporting them in terms of getting those internships. And we are continuously getting those requirements, I can tell you. The requirements are more, and number of people to apply to those requirements are pretty less, right? Talking about employability, Shreyans, interestingly, when you look at employability, I always say this, that employability has two words into it. One is employment, second is ability, right? And we need to focus on both of them. Now, if you look at employment, yes, employment opportunities are pretty large for ACCA qualification across the world. If you look at our job site called jobs.accaglobal.com, you can see that we will have more than 45,000 plus jobs, which are currently active on the website, right? If you talk about India, we'll have around 3,000 plus jobs which have been created post-COVID, right? In this COVID era only, we have been able to create those jobs. 3,000 plus jobs are there. In fact, the number of jobs are more and number of people to apply to those jobs are less. So demand is high and supply is very, very less. Why? It's not because ACCA has come to India, so jobs have been created. It's because India has become the financial hub for the world now. That's why more jobs are coming in, right? So if you look at the jobs, they are in your city in Jaipur. They are in places like Gurgaon, Noida, Chandigarh, where Tashwita stays, right? We have got Lucknow, jobs in Calcutta, in Hyderabad, in Bangalore, in Ahmedabad, in Trivandrum, in Kochi, in Chennai. So all these places, jobs are there. And jobs are in various fields, right? So we're talking about risk management or audit or taxation, right? Or you think about the area which ACCA covers. So ACCA is a holistic qualification. It makes you a wholesome finance professional. So we ensure that you cover each and every area which is related to finance during your qualification, so you can get into any area. So ACCA qualification practically becomes a key for the door towards world of opportunities for you, right? And that's the biggest difference between the ACCA qualification and others. The other thing which is important is working on the ability. Now, Shreyans, and I think Pooja is also here, Tashwita is here, you'll agree with me that ACCA qualification is very practical. It is application-based, and most of the qualification in our country, as well as across the world, are theory-based, right? And that's the biggest differentiator between our qualification and the others. And what we try to do is that we try to kill the gap which is there between what you study in the classroom and what you are asked to work when you get into the workplace, right? So practically what we have done is that we have ensured that each and every paper of ACCA is so much practical and application based that you are able to understand the nuances of the workplace when you are working on those examinations. The other thing is that each and every paper gives you various competencies. Competencies like vision, emotional intelligence, practically the intelligence which is required, creativity, right? Ethical competency as well as technical competency. All these competencies are covered across all the 13 papers of ACCA, which makes you work ready for the future. So we not only focus on the employment for you, we also ensure that we create that ability in you to pick up the employment which is available in the market. So that's the biggest differentiator, and I've seen GCSE working on this for past 6 years to ensure that that ability is there amongst the students, not only the employment, right? So employment will automatically come when you have the right ability. Yeah.
Okay, that's a very comprehensive way to put it. Now, before we move on to the next part, there are two things that I was able to understand and I also want to share is that two things. One is the flexibility. The flexibility is in terms of how you want to plan your qualification, because exams are held every quarter, and now I understand that all the exams are computer based, right? So you can opt for one paper in quarter, two papers in a quarter, or even three papers in a quarter in an extreme scenario. Don't do that usually, right? But so that is one thing. You don't have a very stringent plan that one paper after the other. The first three papers have to be completed and then you can move on to the next six papers. But those six papers can be, you know, taken in any sequence, and the same goes for the last four papers. So that is one thing. And the other thing is also the flexibility in terms of planning your work experience. So for example, if you already have work experience, even before you registered with ACCA, you get credit for it, which is very important, right? Because you don't have to reinvent the wheel, so to speak. So you are getting credit for the experience that you have. And you're also getting credit for the education that you've already done through the exemptions, right? So for example, a BCom graduate gets 4 exemptions, a CA, a fully qualified CA gets 9 exemptions, right? And there are a lot of university programs as well, right? Like the one that that is held at GCSE, where there, because the whole syllabus of ACCA is integrated into the curriculum, so you are exempted from the first 9 papers, if I remember correctly, and you just have to appear for the professional papers correctly, externally, sorry, right? Now, I want to talk about the job side, because let's face it, jobs are a very important factor in choosing any qualification, because it's like one of the end results. So, and again, here I would want to, I have to come to Krishan only, because he probably know the best about the job scenario. Now, I want to know 3 things actually. The one is the sort of profiles, the jobs at the profiles that you want for which ACCA is not the right qualification in India. And I would like to know better specifically with respect to India, because that is more, you know, relevant, and that is all more easily approachable for most of the students. So the jobs in India, the profiles that ACCA serves, the profile that ACCA is not the right one for that. And the third thing is, what sort of packages are we looking at? Pay packages, because again, that's a very important factor for a lot of people.
Okay, thanks Shreyans. So when you look at the job profiles, let me start with that. So job profiles, as I mentioned, that it can be in varied areas, right? So you can get into audit, you can get into taxation, you can get into, say, consulting, you can practically get into financial management in organizations, so, and risk management, etc. So these are various areas in which you can get into post completion of your qualification. In fact, you can get into a job immediately after completing your 9 papers too. Like if you look at KPMG, EY, PwC, Grant Thornton, there are various organizations who are hiring people post their 9 papers only. And a couple of organizations out of them are actually not only paying them salaries, but they are also sponsoring the rest of the qualification for them, right? So they take care of the expenses towards the last 4 papers when it comes to those expenditures. The other thing is that they also provide leaves for people to prepare for the examination and go ahead and write the examination. So that is another advantage which comes for the candidates. Now, talking about the job profiles which are available in India, obviously the majority of the multinational corporations are hiring ACCA right now. However, we have also started working with various Indian companies. Talking about a few of them, we work with ITC, right? Wherein ITC is recruiting people right now. We work with HCL, which is also recruiting people who are qualified in terms of ACCA. We work with Microsoft. We work with Infosys, right? And there are various other organizations. So practically what we do is that we have actually come up with a lot of Indian organizations too, who are hiring ACCAs right now in India. Other than the global employers, we have a very large set of global employers who are definitely doing that right now. So whether they are in the city of Jaipur or in the city which I mentioned in the past. Now, talking about the packages, if you look at the current situation, on an average, somebody who has completed 9 papers is normally hired by the organizations between, say 3.5 to 5 lakhs would be the average CTC, depending on the organization to organization. But this is not only the CTC, there is, in addition to that, the expenses towards the examination and preparation for those examinations, etc., which are also being borne by the organization. In fact, your first membership fee is also being taken care of by various organizations. They take care of it. So that comes as a part of your CTC only, which we have not included it there. If you look at the full-fledged qualification for any professional accountant, right, who has completed his professional accountancy qualification, the average package which is in India right now is around 8.14 lakhs. Yeah, so 8.14 is the average. When I say average, there are people who have been hired at much larger salaries also. There are people who have been hired at salaries which are closer to this number. So let's look at the average only. Let's not look at the macro figures, because macro figures are slightly different, because if you look at somebody who has got 3 years of experience, he was hired by one organization at a package of 55 lakhs. But then that number is very, very small. It will be hardly one or two such people who have done that as on date right now. But then the good thing here is, Shreyans, that the world is open for you, right? So somebody asked me that, what do you do? And he felt that I'll say that I work for an education organization. But when I told him that, yes, I work for an organization which is actually just like a travel agent for you, because we can transport people from one place to another. So we create that opportunity, and ACCA becomes a global passport for individuals to move around. Right, you might have seen it that there are a lot of people who joined organizations like KPMG, EY, etc. in India, and they have moved to places like London and the other places in the world. They are in New Zealand and Australia and other places, right? Immediately after completing 1 or 2 years in their career. So like this, there are opportunities for people to move around, and they can look forward to various opportunities across the world. And there the salaries would be different, right? So if you're in UK, it would be in pounds. If you're in US, it would be in dollars and like that. So it will change accordingly. This is the kind of country and the city you work for. Yeah.
Right. Now, before we move on to taking questions from the students, I just have one last question, and it's going to be a very straightforward question, and I would want Tashweta and Pooja to answer this. Is that who should pursue it and who should not pursue it? It's as simple as that, because let's understand that not every qualification is meant for every student, right? It doesn't matter how good the student is, or it doesn't matter how good the qualification is. There has to be a match with sort of the career that you're looking at, or your ability as such per se as well. So who should pursue ACCA and who should not pursue ACCA? I want Tashweta to start, and I want Pooja ma'am to also give her thoughts on that.
Okay, that is a tricky question now. I think that the person who has, you know, very, you can say, vast interest in commerce field, someone who is, I'm not saying good at, but he should have interest. Don't judge yourself on the basis of your marks which you got in 12th. I mean, they should be above the eligible marks. That's obvious. But you should have interest. Like when I started with it, I never studied accountancy. I did it after 10th. So in 10th, I never studied accountancy. But still, when I, you know, read it for the first time, the debit and credit interested me. The economics, demand, supply, that interested me, right? So you should be basing your decision just on your interest. And ACCA is not about just accountancy. There is one stereotype that, you know, it's just about accountancy, which is not the case. It is more about, you can say, a vast field. Like it includes business, it includes your finance, it includes your taxation, it includes audit. It's not specified. So you get a variety of experience opportunities rather than just focusing on one specific area. So if you have interest, only those students should be joining in this course, and there's no bar for it that if you've done BA, you cannot do this. I've seen people, I've taught students who come from the background of BA, and still they are doing wonders in ACCA. So they don't get the exemptions, but still it's basically how interested you are, because this qualification, I can assure you this much, is not based upon your capacity to mug up or anything. It's based upon your application, you know, how much you understand, how logical you are, and how can you apply your knowledge to a case study. That's what matters in this paper from the very start till the end. So I would say if this interests you, you can go through the curriculum, go through the subjects, and then make your informed decision.
Right. Now, I would also request Pooja to share her thoughts on this, because she has a lot of experience working at different places in the world, and she also has pursued a fair amount of qualifications herself.
Yeah. Thank you, Shreyans. So I think ACCA is meant for students who really want to have international exposure. Okay, somebody who is not looking for opportunities, maybe, you know, I would not say within the country should actually pursue ACCA, but yeah, it becomes more relevant if you plan to move out of the country, or if you have to have that international exposure about international taxation, accounting, you know, finance, reforms, laws, everything. So because it's much more of an international degree. Apart from that, I think I would really vouch on this degree for students who really want to have a holistic development, because it also focuses very strongly upon the practical experience. So, and we quite take it seriously, right? So somebody who's really keen on that practical exposure right from, you know, right after the 12th or right after their school can pursue ACCA. One requirement with ACCA would be good communication or good language, a good hold on the language, because, you know, all the papers are internationally examined, and you know, the center is UK based, so obviously you need to have that good hold on the language, or I would say the command on the language, because yeah, that's a prerequisite, because most of this you know, papers are case study based, and those case studies are all developed outside. I mean, they are, the question papers are not done from India, right? So they are all done from outside. So yeah, that is one requirement. Just a second, guys.
Okay. Yes, ma'am. Please
continue. Can we take it forward from here? I think there is some
noise in the back. All right.
Yeah, so the thrust basically on, you know, somebody who's really wanting to go out of India. Yes, within India we do have some job opportunities, and they're growing up with the years to come. They're actually growing up. All the consultancies, big fours, everyone is employing. Even as Krishan said, ITC is a big time employer of ACC graduates. But yeah, so I would. Shreyans, you can continue from here. So yeah, this is the main thing I wanted to focus upon here. Yeah.
So here's the gist of what we can understand is you have a broad interest in accounting, or the world of commerce, not accounting, the world of commerce, which includes accounting, taxation, finance, corporate finance, and all that stuff. And if you're looking to, I mean, you're looking for international exposure, whether through a company that's present all over the world, or if you are yourself planning to move out, right? So that is one thing. Now I would request the organizer, if we have any questions from the students, so that if they can, you know, unmute and speak, if that's how it works, or if you've already collected questions, however it works, please just take it from here.
Yeah, so we have few questions, and I'm allowing participants to unmute who are raising hands. So
yes, so you will unmute,
can
right?
Just unmute yourself, yeah.
Okay.
Those whoever have questions, yeah, I am allowing you to unmute. Just unmute yourself and ask the questions one by one.
I had a question about if I can take or like do ACCA after taking PCM in 11th.
Okay, so I mean, I'll answer this because
is it necessary to do commerce?
No. So I have friends, I have juniors who were from the science background. I know people who also had bio in their 12th, and even they switched to ACCA, right? Of course, you'll have to put in a little bit of extra effort in the start, because just to get up the basics of accounting, right? Because other than accounting, we don't really study anything else in 11th and 12th, right? All the finance, it's not taught in school or anything. So you'll have to, and in the initial three papers, those basics are explained well enough as well, right? So probably, let's say, you know, for example, after a 12th, we have a science, so you probably, Hanji.
Sorry for the interruption. I would like to take this question.
Okay, sure, please go ahead.
Okay, so as you know, I am from science background. I completed my 12th in Sri Chaitanya Technical Institute, Visakhapatnam, and I was trying for JEE Mains and Advanced, but now I am doing my ACCA. And trust me, it's not that difficult as people think. It hardly took me 2 months to grab the basics of accounting. So it's not that tough, if you say.
So I think that answers it the best. We'll move on to the next question.
Excuse me. Am I audible?
Yes, please. Go ahead.
If I don't have maths, can't I take ACCA?
From what I remember, the eligibility criteria was you have to have a 65% plus in either maths or accounts. Right, probably Krishan could explain it better.
So you can definitely take admission in ACCA, that's not a problem at all. So what happens is, for the qualification, which is ACCA directly, you need to have 65% maths and accountancy, maths or accountancy. In case you don't have that marks, you will be admitted through the FIA route. There's no difference between FIA and ACCA. It's just that the route has been created for you to enter into the qualification. Instead of you writing, say, financial accounting, you'll be writing foundations in financial accounting. That's the only difference, right? Otherwise, the diploma and the advanced diploma, everything remains the same in the qualification.
So,
in fact, you can start doing it before.
Yes, you definitely can.
Yeah.
Right. Perfect. Next question, please.
Hello.
Please go ahead.
My question is, after pursuing ACCA, like Tashwada Didi is pursuing MSc in professional accountancy, what can we pursue, what other courses can we pursue? Like, I personally have interest in economics also. So I was like thinking after pursuing some degree in economics. So what are all the options available? Or is it necessary to do a master's degree after doing ACCA?
Okay.
Does it help for that?
Interesting question. Shreyans, let me
Tashwita,
take
you want to go ahead?
Okay, Tashwita, you can take it and I'll add
and
on.
And then even Krishan could add his thoughts.
Yeah, so as far as I know, I think master's is not at all important. My objective was to do a PhD. That's why I opted for MSc, because I'm into teaching. So that was the rationale behind me choosing an MSc. And if you talk about other qualifications, if you are interested in economics, I mean, there are many other things you can, I think it's actuarial sciences is there, and you have CFA, you have other options like if you're interested in audit, you have ICAEW and many other qualifications. You can do an MBA, whatever you want to do. I mean, ACCA is like a, you know, one step which you've taken. Other than that, you can do anything. So you can do your UPSC even after that. So there's no such hard and fast rule that I have to do this thing after doing ACCA.
Yeah. So, and I'll just add to this. Now, so what happens is each and every level of ACCA has got equivalence level in UK and European Union, right? If you look at the Diploma in Accounting and Business, that's level 4 as per the official qualification of UK, which means that it is equivalent to first year of your graduation. If you look at the advanced diploma, it's equivalent to a graduation, and your entire ACCA qualification is equivalent to a post-graduation, which I'm talking about it from the point of view of you going and studying further in UK, etc. In fact, this relevance, the equivalence is there in markets like Australia, New Zealand, Middle East, Singapore also. They are actually giving the similar credits to the ACCA qualification there. In fact, most of the top universities in Australia, New Zealand, Singapore, Middle East, and Europe, they are actually offering ACCA qualification in their post-graduation as well as graduation programs itself. Further to that, in case you want an MBA also other than the MSc as Tashwita is doing, you can get it from Oxford Brookes University or University of Ireland in Dublin. You have this another option which is there. In fact, we have created an MBA option in India too with Birla Institute of Management Technology. In case you are interested, you can very well go ahead and pursue that. Otherwise, whether it is economics or financial analysis or anything, you are free to get into it, because as Shreyans mentioned, we started as an accounting qualification in 1904, moved to finance, and today we are talking about business leadership, right? So Tashwita, you also touched upon that. So we're talking about business leadership because business leaders are more important for the organizations of future, right? And in fact, the 56% of the new CEOs in organizations, they come with finance and accounting background.
So, I mean, I just try to quickly wrap it up again, is that first focus on your primary thing that you want to do after 12, because while you're pursuing your qualification, a lot of things change about how you want to plan your career, right? So don't think too far ahead. Have a brief idea, try to experiment with different things, and then figure out what works best for you. You don't need to be so hard and fast with respect to qualifications, right? All right, so we have more questions. I am understanding. The next person can please go ahead. If you want to
guys,
ask
in case you have any questions, please raise your hands and I'll let you unmute.
Yeah, so there will be an option to raise your hands, or then you'll be unmuted. So I think there are a couple of people who raised their hands.
Shreya, you can unmute yourself.
I wanted to ask that if we can get international jobs with ACCA, what is the significance of CPA, like CPA Canada, CPA Australia and America?
Okay, Krishan, you want to go ahead and answer that?
Okay, okay. So Shreya, the name of the student is Shreya, right? So Shreya, each and every qualification has got its own importance, right? And CPA is a US qualification, CPA Canada is another qualification from Canada. In fact, interestingly, what happens is each and every country has got their own qualification, right? So as we have got Institute of Chartered Accountants of India, when you go to Pakistan, you have Institute of Chartered Accountants of Pakistan, right? You go to Nepal, you have Institute of Chartered Accountants of Nepal. You go to Singapore, you have CA Singapore, as you have mentioned, CPA Canada, CPA USA, CA Australia, New Zealand. Like this, every country has got their own local body. Now, every qualification, as I said, it has its own reputation and respect, and we should respect what they are doing. However, I can tell you about how ACCA would be different. That, as I mentioned, we are a very much globally relevant qualification, and that's why we ensure that our ACCA is ACCA anywhere in the world. There is no difference between an ACCA who has done the qualification from, say, Jaipur, or an ACCA who has done it from Chandigarh, or from New York, or from London, or from Sydney. All the people are known as ACCA across the world. It's the same community across 180 countries, right? So that's the large network that we have of 5,50,000 plus students who have who are pursuing this qualification, and 2,27,000 members, right? So you have this opportunity of being part of that network which is there across the world. So we ensure that, yes, one qualification and one designation takes you places. Now, for the other qualification, it would depend on country to country, from state to state, things might change, but for ACCA, it will remain the same. So that much I can tell you here, right? For the rest of the qualifications, I cannot comment on them because, as I mentioned, they are highly respected and reputed qualifications. You might like to check about them on Google, so you can very well go ahead and check the differences there. Yeah, Tashwita.
Yeah, one thing I want to add here is I think there is some MOU between CPA Canada and ACCA and CPA Australia and ACCA as well. So if you have a bachelor's with you, as far as I have researched, so if you have a bachelor's with you and you've done ACCA, so there is a MOU between ACCA and CPA Canada. So I think it's in Ontario. If I move on there and I submit my documents, so I'll be called as CPA Canada there if I have a bachelor's in ACCA. Similarly for Australia as well.
Yeah, Tashwita, just to add, there are 78 such countries wherein we have got such MOUs, right? And students have an option. Like, for example, if you go to UAE, you need to submit your ACCA qualification related documents, and you can get an approval and a license to operate as a UAECA without writing any exams there. But when you go to the other countries, each country might have their own requirement. You might be asked to write the local tax and local law exam to become the local CA of that country. Like as you rightly mentioned, CPA Canada, you have to write the local tax and local law exam to become the CPA Canada. Right, you go to Australia, CA Australia, New Zealand, you just write two exams and you become CA Australia, New Zealand. So like this, there are 78 countries where people, after completing the qualification, can go ahead and become the local chartered accountant of that country. Yeah.
All right, so I'm so sorry to say, but we're running out of time. We're already past the time. So we'll have to wrap up the session right now. I'll just have a few closing comments. The first is, I understand that a lot of students still have a lot of questions. So for that, what you could do is just go to community.commerceclave.com or just reach out to the any person from the organizing team who are the coordinator about the event details. They will fix up something either through the community or through a session with anybody so that you get all your questions answered. Don't worry about it. Just reach out to anyone from the organizing team or just log into community.commerceclave.com. Right, and you'll find all the details there. So unfortunately we have to wrap right now because of the shortage of time. At last, I would like to thank everyone, first of all the students, for being responsible enough to understand that okay, I need to, you know, plan my career and be responsible about it. So kudos to that. And next, I would also want to thank all the lovely people who've spent out their times, Tashweta, Krishan and Pooja ma'am. So thank you so much for being here. And let's see, I mean, thanks to all the students. And if there is anything you need from anyone's side, please don't hesitate to reach out. Thank you so much. And we'll try. Thank you so much. Bye-bye.
Thank you.
Shreyans.
Bye-bye.
Thank you. Bye. Yeah, thank you.
Thank you, everyone.